day commissioners board meeting for March the 17th of 2022. We're broadcasting live on Microsoft Teams live event, as well as BCTV and YouTube and Facebook live. At this time, I want to recognize Commissioner Barnhart's executive assistant, Jesse Blauser. Jesse.
Public comment will be accepted in person and through the Q&A function. Please include your first name, last name, and municipality for all comments. Any comments without name and municipality will not be considered. Each citizen can submit one comment. Comment length is dictated by limitations of the platform being used, Teams Q&A, Facebook, YouTube. In-person comments will be accepted first, followed by comments submitted virtually. The meeting comment period is limited to a total of 30 minutes, including both in-person and virtual comments. This time period may be extended at the discretion of the board. Please be concise. Comments that are germane to county business will be read during the meeting and should not be considered to be interactive dialogue with the commissioners. The county solicitor shall be the final arbiter of whether a comment is germane and should be read. Any commissioner response to public comment will be done at the discretion of the commissioners.
Thank you very much, Jesse. At this time, we'll begin as we always do with a moment of silence followed by a pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Are there any additions or corrections for the March 10th commissioner meeting minutes and the March 14th special commissioners meeting minutes? Hearing none, the minutes will stand approved as presented. And I realized we had an executive session yesterday. It dealt with personnel. Anything else? Just personnel, okay. Normally I reach out to our solicitor and I forgot, so I wanted to make sure. We'll begin this morning with a presentation. We have Peter Edelman from Stevens and Lee here. And this is in regard to a request regarding Phoebe Services, Inc. Peter.
Thank you, Commissioner Leinbach. Good morning, Commissioner Barnhart.
Good morning.
Yes, I am here today on behalf of Phoebe Berks, Devitt Homes. They are moving forward with a tax-exempt bond financing to benefit facilities that Phoebe owns both in Lehigh County and also here in Berks County. I think everybody's aware of the retirement community in Warnersville. Proceeds of a series of 2008 bonds were used to finance some capital improvement projects at the Warnersville campus. This new financing on behalf of Phoebe is up to $124 million and includes a new community in Emmaus, Lehigh County, but also includes the refunding of the 2008 bonds. As you've done in the past for other charitable organizations here in Berks County, the Board of Commissioners has to approve this project as a requirement of the Internal Revenue Code following a public hearing to give members of the public an opportunity to ask questions and comment about the proposed project. The hearing was conducted last week. No members of the public attended. So the resolution before the commissioners today really simply approves the project as required by the Internal Revenue Code and also makes clear that the county is in no way obligated whatsoever with respect to the debt, but rather this is just a ministerial approval as required as a condition to issuance of the bonds.
Right. What it really is for people to understand, it protects us if this would be a project that is clearly not beneficial to the community. It would give us the ability to go on record in opposition and not approve this. So I think it's a good system. It's right. Not really about finances. It's about what is good and proper for the community. So
that's right.
Any other comments? I will accept a motion.
I will 84-2022 adopt the resolution approving the section permitting the process to move forward.
I will second that motion. The motion has been made and seconded. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The motion is carried. Thank you very much, Peter.
Thank you.
At this time, is there any public comment on specific agenda items? Thank you very much. And we will continue into the agenda. Item one, authorizing under that budget department, adopt a resolution authorizing 2021 budget transfers in the amount of $2,490,427 and 2022 budget transfers in the amount of $130,000 and 2022 appropriations in the amount of $1,568,454 per listing dated March 11th of 2022. There are two items listed under Human Resources. Item one, authorize the appointment of Tylea Batance to Human, and I said that wrong, didn't I, the last name?
Oh,
I'm pretty close. Tylea? Tylea Batance. To Human Resources Generalist in Human Resources. I should have asked about that name beforehand. Item two, authorize the promotion of Troy Wolf from Sergeant to Captain in the Sheriff's Department. One item under the Solid Waste Authority, adopt a resolution approving submission of the application for reimbursement for a county recycling coordinator to the Pennsylvania Department of Environmental Protection, Bureau of Waste Management for reimbursement of 50% of the salary, benefits, and expenses paid to the Berks County Recycling Coordinator for calendar year 2021. There are several items listed under the commissioners. Item A, adopt a resolution authorizing execution of the hazardous material emergency response report certifications for the hazardous material emergency response preparedness report for reporting year of 2021. Item B, adopt a resolution authorizing execution of the Pennsylvania Commission on Crime and Delinquency application for subgrant seeking full funding for a part-time forensic interviewer position within the district attorney's office. Item C, adopt a resolution authorizing Brian Gottschall, Director of Emergency Services, to execute an agreement between the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania acting through its Department of Conservation and Natural Resources, French Creek Park, and the County of Berks to provide local dispatch services. Item D, adopt a resolution authorizing Brian Gottschall, Director of Emergency Services, to execute the Memorandum of Understanding between Schuylkill County and its 911 Communications Department and Berks County and its Department of Emergency Services, permitting each county to program the other county's radio system into the radios of certain emergency responders to improve coordination and support over county borders. Item E, adopt a resolution authorizing the chair to execute the 2021 Court Interpreter Services Grant from the Administrative Office of Pennsylvania Courts in the reimbursement request amount of $400,711.93 to provide on-site, in-person courtroom interpreting services at the Court of Common Pleas and Magisterial District Judge levels. Item F, adopt a resolution authorizing the chair to execute the 2021 Senior Judge Reimbursable Cost Grant from AOPC in the reimbursement request amount of $79,100 to offset the cost of senior judges and their staff. Item G, adopt a resolution authorizing the chief administrative officer or deputy CAO to execute future resident balance payment agreements between the County of Berks on behalf of Berksheim Nursing and Rehabilitation and Berksheim residents, their authorized representatives, and or guarantors. Item H, adopt a resolution authorizing execution of a letter of support of Berks County Pretrial Services application for funding through the current Pennsylvania Commission on Crime and Delinquency solicitation for 2021-2022 JAG local initiatives funding under objective 2.6, increase availability of high quality reentry programs and practices across the Commonwealth. Item I, adopt a resolution authorizing Christine Sadler Esquire and solicitor to execute the engagement agreement with Kozloff Stout Attorneys for legal services pertaining to the Reading Regional Airport Authority. Item J, adopt a resolution approving an assignment and assumption agreement between Complete Health Resources Eastern Inc. as assigner, CHR Consulting Services Inc. as assignee, and the County of Berks approving the assignment of the management services agreement for the Berksheim from CHRE to CHR Consulting. Item K, adopt a resolution approving the terms of a grant agreement with the Pennsylvania Department of Agriculture for funding of a county project for an interactive on-farm workshop focused in the Saucony and Lower Maiden Creek watersheds to be provided by the Berks County Agricultural Land Preservation Board. Item L, adopt a resolution authorizing the county to execute an agreement with the Berks County Redevelopment Authority to administer a grant to the county from the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania in the amount of $12,711,796.54 from the Commonwealth's allocation of the American Rescue Plan funds for the county's Emergency Rental Assistance Program. Item two, a motion to authorize execution of a contract agreements and amendments as set forth on the attached listing dated March the 14th of 2022. There are a total of three contracts, one with the Berks Library System, one with Mental Health and Developmental Disabilities, and one with Parks and Rec. Item three, a motion to authorize execution of the payments and electronic transfers as set forth on the Controller's Office voucher listing dated March the 17th of 2022.
I'll motion to approve the agenda with the exception of striking 99-2022. That should be stricken from the agenda.
Okay, not a problem. It will be stricken. I will second the motion. The motion's been made and seconded. Is there any other discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, the motion is carried. At this time, we'll turn to our treasurer's report, and sitting in for our county treasurer is the deputy, Linda Weaver. Linda.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We have an opening balance of $157,120,831.27. We have a balance to clear of $5,507,733.46, leaving us with a balance of $151,613,097.81.
Thank you very much. And now the controller's report, and we have the deputy Grazina Nikiel to give that report.
Good morning, commissioners.
Good morning.
Total disbursements for March 17th, accounts payable were $14,007,491.83. It was a payroll week, so total combined payroll amounted to $4,685,596.78, which amounted to total cash disbursements of $18,693,88.61.
Thank you very much. And we'll move now to our Chief Administrative Officer, Ron Seaman.
Thank you, Commissioner. With moving from meteorological spring to actual spring this coming Sunday, we see a great deal of new programming coming out of our Park and Recreation Department for the next several months. All the details on these programs can be found on the county website, as well as the Park and Recreation Facebook page. But one I'd like to call attention to is scheduled for Saturday, March the 26th. I think this is a fairly new concept that the parks are trying. It's a ranger-led photography hike, and it'll take place at Grings Mill Park from 9 till 10:30 a.m. And pre-registration for this event is required. So check out all the new programming that's come forth for the months of remaining part of March and April and May, and I'd like all of you to come out and enjoy our beautiful park system. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ron. We'll move now to commissioners' reports, and I'll turn to Commissioner Kevin Barnhart.
Thank you, Commissioner Linebach. Good morning, everyone, and some pleasant news out of the youth recreation field located on County Welfare Road in Burn Township. Will be a huge soccer tournament this weekend. One of the fields, the main field, has been resurfaced with artificial turf. The second field is in process, probably will be finished by middle of next week. Ran into some weather-related issues this week, but there are up to 88 different teams playing throughout the weekend. So if you're a soccer aficionado, please head up to the youth recreation field to see the kickoff of what I think is going to be a really exciting year and years into the future with activities with baseball, softball, and soccer at the youth recreation fields. Today at 11 a.m., we have election board. We have some interesting items. In particular, we are going to be proposed moving one of the precincts, Precinct 8, Muhlenberg Township, from the Township Fire and Rescue Station to Good Shepherd Lutheran Church on Stouts Ferry Bridge Road. We're also going to be approving ballot position lottery for people that are in contested races. This would be for next Friday at 10:30 a.m. in the Services Center Auditorium. You should be receiving a letter in the mail early next week notifying you if you're interested in coming in to draw your ballot position for your position on the ballot. And we're going to discuss poll worker training and poll worker pay. We're hopefully going to elevate people this morning to give them some additional compensation for poll worker training. These are the same people that work election day, but we feel as though there might be something to be said for their training day and what their compensation is. Today at 1 o'clock, we continue with the Berks County Correctional Facility Steering Committee here in person in the boardroom. And last but not least, I want to remind people again, the rescue dollar applications. We are accepting applications through March 31st. Please apply. And also, it's on the website to apply if you're a requesting infrastructure funding consideration, not-for-profit support, and business and workforce development. But also, there's a survey, a very brief survey, but very informative information for the county to move forward. We want to have you fill out the survey, even though you may or may not be applying for consideration for rescue dollars. But please fill out the survey. It will give us information moving forward as to what focus we should have here in the greater Berks County community and where these rescue dollars should be allocated. So please, on the county website, countyofberks.com, either fill out your application. We want to hear from you if you feel that you've suffered significantly from the pandemic and need rescue dollar support, as well as fill out the survey. If you're not in line for the rescue dollars, it really will help us to fill out that information so we can prioritize where the money will go. Thank you, Commissioner Linebach.
Thank you, Commissioner Barnhart. Two items I want to touch on. 2 weeks from today, we will host our first on-the-road commissioners meeting of 2022. It will take place at the Hamburg Area High School on March the 31st. And it will be in the evening at 7 p.m. I want to encourage people, especially if you're in that area of northern Berks, come on out. We'd love to meet you, love to hear from you. The meeting will also be available virtually. We're doing both, even when we're on the road. So mark that down in your calendars. 2 weeks from today, March 31st, Hamburg Area High School at 7 p.m. And we will hear a brief presentation, I believe, by Mayor Holmes from Hamburg. The Hamburg Borough is the one that requested the meeting, and we're glad to be able to go up to the northern part of the county. That's my neck of the woods. The second item, this Sunday, the County Commissioners Association of Pennsylvania Spring Conference begins. I'll be in a board meeting on Sunday morning. Some of the topics that we'll be dealing with over the course of Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday morning will be Sunday afternoon, actually, a broadband summit, a number of counties getting together, sharing some best practice information. There's a session dealing with changing demographics in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. There's at least one session dealing with American Rescue Plan dollars. There's a session dealing with election issues, another session dealing with county assessment department issues and challenges, and there's a special session on stepping up. Commissioner Barnhart, as many people may be aware, has headed the Stepping Up initiative since it began here in Berks County. That's more than that. 5 or 6 years ago, I think it's actually even more than that. It was just talking to Justin Luce. Time flies, and the pandemic makes it tougher to remember the timing. But Commissioner Barnhart's led that from the beginning. Berks is one of a handful of counties in the entire country that has become a demonstration county. Doesn't mean we do it all right. It means that we've progressed further than most other counties. And this deals with addressing the issues of mental health in the criminal justice system in our county jail. We continue to make progress, but there'll be a session at CCAP dealing with that issue as well. That is all that I have. Any comments from row officers? Okay, with that, we will go to public comment. And yes, go ahead. And I know the gentleman, Russ Cambria from Las Vegas. Go ahead.
Russ Cambria, it's now been a full decade. Please consider a plan to relight the top of the courthouse.
Okay. Any other questions?
There was one additional comment. It is John Hollinger, Why Missing PA.
Okay.
I am concerned about Paige Rigner's refusal to discuss the 2020 election. My calls to county commissioners were dismissed, and yesterday I was threatened by Commissioner Barnhart that he would take additional measures to ensure I don't seek additional clarification from the election service offices. He refused to elaborate when I asked over the phone and by email. It is illegal to ask election services director to clarify her one the record comments on the 2020 election.
Any other comments?
Yep.
Hearing none. Echo. Okay, I think we...
it actually is appropriate that you have the echo, because I could respond to Russ Cambridge's request, which we've done. It wasn't mine. I had mine off.
Okay.
We've responded to this request about relighting the courthouse numerous times, and really the main issue is the potential of having interference on our 911 radio system.
Right.
There is no guarantee if you put lights on the top of the courthouse where significant amount of our 911 emergency radio system equipment is housed would cause interference on that emergency radio system. So that is the main driver of not relighting the courthouse lights. again, it was at least 10 years ago where we had estimates in excess of six figures to relight the courthouse lights. That was a consideration as well, but it was really the potential of interference on our emergency radio system lights.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a question of aesthetics versus public safety,
right,
and not a risk that we want to take. But I do appreciate Russ has been active. He was a resident here and moved, I believe he's in Las Vegas now, working out there. John Hollinger, it's important that you state things correctly. I did not dismiss you. I spoke to you on the phone and we conversed about it. I told you then, and we've reiterated numerous times, Paige was fully vetted. You can make this political, but it isn't. She is nonpartisan, and she is committed to running the department in a way that all Berks Countyans can be proud of the way it is operated. I support her fully. My colleagues support her fully, and I just try to get your facts right. I did not dismiss you. I spoke to you as I try to do with anyone that reaches out to my office. Any other comment? Okay.
Motion to adjourn.
The meeting is adjourned.